success when it was presented at the Savoy. Something brand new had been added to the dance, and from this point, it's possible to say that the Lindy Hopin, at least when talking about shows and competitions, more and more took to the air. In Hollywood, they made several movies, including The Marx Brothers, A Day at the Races, Radio City Rebels, and Hell's a Poppin'. Frankie also recalls that in 1936, the dancers themselves decided to use Whitey's name in their artistic name. At this particular time, there were three different Savoy-based groups around, one of them working in California under the name of Whitey's Lindy Hoppers. Another one, which Frankie belonged to, was performing at the famous Cotton Club in Harlem. Using the group was named Tiny Bunch and his original Lindy Hoppers. The time is now around 1937. Lindy Hopin and swing music are about to reach their peaks. Big bands are heard everywhere, and the Lindy Hop, which just a few years before had been considered strictly a black dance, is now a dance for both blacks and whites. The Savoy is in its heyday and is also the natural home for Whitey's Lindy Hoppers. Right across the street from the Savoy, the Lindy Hoppers had their own clubhouse where they could relax, practice steps, or whatever.